Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. This is Mayuri. So before we begin this video, I really hope everybody is staying home and everybody's safe. I hope all your family members are safe. As all of you are staying back home currently due to the lockdown situation, I thought this can be the best time to go out a few tips on how to plan a budget-friendly trip. So you can plan a budget-friendly trip soon after the lockdown is over and when the situation gets better. So let's start with the tips. So the first one is the location. So when you talk about location, you need to decide on if you want to travel in your own country or if you want to go on an international trip. So here, when you talk about international trip, you need to keep in mind of the currency exchange rate that you go through from one country's currency to the other country's currency. And if you're traveling national, that is in your own country, then you really not have to worry about that. So that's totally fine. So talking about international trip, if you do not have a huge budget, then you could plan to few countries which don't really incur much expenses, like Bhutan, Bali and Thailand. So the second point is budget. So when talking about a budget, you need to think about how much money do you have and how long can you plan, like how many days trip can you plan in that much budget. It's really important that you allocate your budget into different parts, wherein you could divide it for food, accommodation, travel and other expenses. So that's one thing that you have to keep in mind, that your budget has to allocate all of these things. The number of days of your trip also depends on the budget that you have. So according to your budget, you have to decide on the number of days that you could travel. So the third point is transportation. So when you talk about transportation here, transportation can be divided into various aspects. If you're traveling to a very far off place, then you need to take a flight. And flight could cost about a lot of money and you really need to book in advance. That's one thing that you can do. If you plan a trip abroad and if you wanna travel by flight, you need to make sure that you book your trip at least 2 months in advance. It's really important. That way you could also get an early bird offer or a lesser price. Or else if you're just traveling from one state to another state or within your own state, then you could also take a bus or a train. I usually travel by train, that too sleeper class, because it's really convenient and most of the journeys are at night and you could just sleep it off. So that's one thing. And not necessary you have to go by an AC train. You could just go through a normal sleeper class train. It just takes up about 300 to 400 rupees one way journey. So in that way, your to and fro journey could be covered in 1000 rupees if you travel to go by train. Not that really comfortable with the trains, then you could also take up a sleeper bus. That would cost about 1000 to 1500 rupees one way, and it's pretty much convenient going in a bus. The fourth point is your accommodation. So there are a lot of places that you can actually opt for accommodation. I don't really have much idea about internationally. When I actually travel an international trip, I usually go through any agencies like Make My Trip or Trip Factory and get my accommodation booked in advance. I usually travel solo and I make sure all my accommodation is done well in advance, at least 1 to 2 months in advance. If you're a backpacker, you don't really have to worry. Majority of the places have hostel facilities. That's really nice. That would cost you about 300 to 400 or max up to 500. And you get like a bunk bed, you will have safety lockers to keep your things, and you'll also have Wi-Fi security, and mostly it'll be cool crowd, so not to worry about. The policies are really nice. They'll make sure your stay is really nice. So the fifth thing that comes is food. So it is really important that any place you visit, you really got to have the local food at that place. Otherwise there's no point. It's not like you enjoyed anything in that place. One good way to save money on food is to have local food. Not necessary you'll have to go to a 5-star restaurant or a very luxurious restaurant to have food. You can have the tasty and hygienic food even at the local small store, and also you can get to enjoy the authentic, that taste famous food. So that's one way. And also if you want, you could carry cup noodles or some dry rotis or some snacks with you. which could help you in pushing a little longer, like having an evening snack, or you could just pour a hot water from your hotel on in your cup noodles and have noodles for breakfast. So that's another way of saving money on food. And as per I've noticed so far in all of my trips, food doesn't really take up that much cost in your budget. I usually end up spending about 500 to 600 a day maximum for food, that's it. And even sometimes I just end up spending 200 or 300 in my daily budget for food, because I end up eating at the local food stalls which really provide some amazing food. Next point is local transport. So we are done about the transport of reaching from one place to the destination place. So now next comes is the local transport. I have so far noticed that any place you go, any tourist place, offers you two-wheeler services. So you can rent a two-wheeler, and a few places you also get to hire a bicycle. But bicycle I don't really recommend, because it could eat up all of your energy, and reaching from one place to another place could take a lot of time, and that could not be safe also. So hiring a two-wheeler or taking a shared auto is most preferable. So one experience that I could tell you is when I was in Agra, I also got these Tanga services. So that was really amazing. I just paid about 10 rupees per kilometer, and I traveled around 10 kilometers and just paid about 100 rupees. So I saved a lot in Agra when I traveled there. I took an entire day trip and it was amazing. You can also hitchhike, but I don't recommend hitchhike because it could not be safe, and I personally do not prefer hitchhiking. But you think if the environment is good enough and you have and you're traveling with a group of friends, then maybe hitchhiking could also be an option. There are a lot of travelers who actually hitchhike from their start point till the end point and reach there with absolutely no cost. So you could also do that if you think that it could be safe. So you can do that. Last tip for today is miscellaneous expenses. So when you plan a trip, you always need to keep a separate tab of miscellaneous expenses, wherein you'll have a little extra money kept for emergencies. So here, miscellaneous expenses could be like entrance fee at few places, camera charges at few places, or if you would like to shop at few places. But my recommendation is carry light, travel light. So that way you'll be able to carry your luggage anywhere and go, and not necessarily you will definitely need a cab to carry your luggage. So if you just have a backpack, it's really easier. You could just travel anywhere. So if you plan to do some shopping at any place that you travel, then that could add up your miscellaneous expenses. All for today's video. So when I plan a trip, I keep all of these points into consideration, and my budget, and plan an entire trip well in advance and do all my bookings so that I get the best deal. I would also like to add a note to this, that I sometimes travel with my group of friends or with just a friend, which really works out for me. That way I also get to share the accommodation, transport, and all of those things. So that's it for my video. I hope these tips were helpful for you, and I hope you guys plan a great budget-friendly trip. And if you guys also have any suggestions or any tips for me that you guys follow in planning a nicer budget-friendly trip, then do comment below and let me know how you plan your budget-friendly trip. And I hope this video was helpful, and I'll see you guys in my next video.